Our chalice lighting this morning is a Mother's Day chalice lighting by Claudine Olivia. We light this chalice in tribute to the mothers in each of us. We light this chalice to celebrate those people who have taken on the task of raising a baby into childhood, youth, and adulthood. To celebrate those who have nourished the light of truth and compassion in growing minds and hearts. To celebrate those who have committed time, money, energy to the children of this world. We light this chalice to celebrate and hold dear this flame of love. Or not. Okay, there's a chalice like flaming in our hearts. Mother's Day is beautiful and difficult and simple and complicated. It happens every year, whether you want it or not. It happens if your mom has died. It happens if you wish she would. It happens if you are a mom by chance or by choice, against your will or joyfully. It happens if you just found out you cannot have a child, or if you never want one, no matter what. It happens if your mom was the best thing ever, or if she barely knew you were around. For good or bad, the day arrives and the cards come out in the stores and the Hallmark moments happen. It happens for those of us with our children and for those of us who wish we were. For those of us who hit our child today and for those who were the child that was hit. No matter what, it's Mother's Day. So come to church with us and let us celebrate the joy and the struggle, the laughter and the pain. Even in the broken places, there is room for love and laughter. Even in the perfect places, there are moments to hold one another. Come and let us be here together. Good morning and welcome to the First Unitarian Church of Des Moines. I'm Heidi Levine. My pronouns are she, her, hers, and I am serving as the celebrant today. No matter where you are or where you come from, you are welcome here, whether or not you live in Des Moines or have ever physically been at First Unitarian. Whoever you are, we hope that you find here thoughts which challenge you, welcome which invites you into community, and people to accompany you as you journey. I'm speaking to you now from land that is the traditional territory of the Indigenous Iowa people. Reverend Amy Petrie Shaw is preaching today. Bruce Martin is our pianist. Barb Martin is our soloist and song leader. And Anne Mowry is the pastoral care associate for this week. Lyra Halston, our membership coordinator, is here with us. And if you would like to be connected to our online groups or would like additional information about First Unitarian, please contact her through the email address in the chat. Please keep your microphones muted during the entire service. And after the service, everyone is welcome to unmute and join us in the coffee hour breakout rooms. Our gathering song this morning is number 346, Come Sing a Song With Me. The words will be in the chat screen. Please leave your mics muted and simply sing along at home as you wish.
Sing a song with me. dream with me. Come dream a dream with me. Come dream a dream with me. The time I long for mine. And I'll bring you hope when hope is hard to find. And I'll bring a song of love and a rose in the winter.
Our Time for All Ages story this morning is A Tale of Two Mommies by Vanita Olschlanger, illustrated by Mike Blank, and it's going to be read by Devin McClurkin and Olson. Yep.
I'm Devin McClurkin, Director of Faith Formation here at First Unitarian, and this is Olson, and we are going to be reading A Tale of Two Mommies. Olson, how many moms do you have?
Two.
Right. A Tale of Two Mommies, written by Vanita Olschlanger, and illustrations by Mike Blank. If you have a mama and a mommy, who fixes things when they break? Oh, mommy has all the tools. There's nothing she can't fix or make. Who's your mom for riding a bike? Who's your mom for flying a kite? Mama's the one for riding a bike. She's also the one for flying a kite. Which mom's there when you want to go fishing? Which mom helps when Kitty goes missing? Mommy helps when I want to go fishing. Both mommies help when Kitty goes missing. Glub, glub, glub. Translation. Who's your mom when you set up your campsite? Who's your mom with scary faces with flashlights? Mommy helps set up the campsite. Mama makes great scary faces with a flashlight. Which mom coaches your t-ball team? Which mom's there when you've had a bad dream? Mommy is the coach of my t-ball team. And both mommies are there when I've had a bad dream. Who's your mom when you're climbing a tree? Who's your mom when you've scraped your knee? Mama helps me climb a tree. And both moms help when I skin my knee. What's he got?
Help me. Yeah.
Who empties your pockets at the end of the day?
Why is her tipping her head down?
Yeah, she's looking at his ears, huh? Who teaches you the polite thing to say? I empty my own pockets at the end of the day. Both moms know what's a polite thing to say. Does either mom like to pet a snake? Which mom likes to bake some cake? Neither mom really likes a snake, but mommy really likes to bake the cakes. Who's your mom for making beans and rice? Who helps you out when your friends aren't nice? Mommy makes me beans and rice. She also helps when my friends aren't nice. Which mom sorts your collections of rocks? Which mom is there when you just need to talk?
My baby.
I'm the one who sorts my rocks. And of course, both moms are there when I need to talk. Can you talk to both moms?
Hello.
Yeah.
Happy Mother's Day. Can you say Happy Mother's Day?
Happy Mother's Day.
Thank you very much, Devin and Olson. I want to do a quick spotlight now on General Assembly, which is coming up quicker than you can imagine. The annual conference of the Unitarian Universalist Association, the UUA, will be held virtually from June 23rd through the 27th. Everyone is welcome to attend. It is an amazing experience. If you've never gone, it's $200 for the whole thing. We're doing it digitally again. It is so worth it. The big news is the WARE lecture this year will be Stacey Abrams. And she is a political activist and the New York Times bestselling author of Our Time Is Now and Lead From Outside. She's the one who got out the vote in Georgia. She did not get elected, but she got the most votes of any Democratic candidate ever in Georgia. So she is going to be there. And also Desmond Mead, the chair of the Florida Rights Restoration Coalition. It is going to be amazing. You do not want to miss that lecture. Anyone can register for and attend GA. We need delegates. We need 9 people willing to vote for our congregation to represent who we are. Registration again is $200. Financial assistance is available for delegates, especially if you have never ever been a delegate before. We don't want finances to stop you from volunteering. So talk to me, email me, message me. We'll get it figured out if you want to be a delegate. Check out the GA site, uua.org/GA for detailed info. Only certain things are recorded. So you cannot get access to all of the bits of GA if you are not going to GA. And again, if you've never been to GA or you've never been a delegate and you really, really, really want to do this, please talk to me. We will find a way to make it possible for you. There's the what to put in Google to get you to GA. So again, please consider it. During GA, our Mid-America region will be holding its annual meeting, and we are also seeking delegates for that. You do not need to register for GA to attend the Mid-America region meeting. Those are 2 different things. If you have any questions, please message me. I'll be glad to bring you up to speed. It's great. Consider going. It's time for our offering, and I do that in my usual serious style. Early one Sunday morning, a woman went to wake up her daughter. "Wake up, it's time to go to church." "But why, Mom?" the daughter said. "I don't want to go." "Give me 2 reasons you don't want to go," the mother said. "Well, it's hot, and the sermons are so boring." "Oh, that's no reason not to go to church. Come on and get ready." "Mom, give me 2 reasons why I should go to church." "Well, for one, you're 52 years old. And for another, you're the minister. Now get up and get moving." Now, I have to admit, it took me a minute to get up and get moving this morning. But since I'm here and dressed, we might as well pass the plate. This morning's offering will be given and received through the link in the chat. And as always, 1/2 goes to our internal social justice work and 1/2 goes external to our Faith in Action Partners for the Year, Planned Parenthood, and Central Iowa Immigrant Support Coalition. Thank you. Thank you for the gifts that you bring to this community. It's important because a church isn't just the building, as we found out over the last year. The church is all about the community. Community of human hearts, a community of human hands, a community that comes together to share the laughter and the tears and to be there for one another in the good times and the bad times and all the in-between times. Got a couple of joys for this week. Elaine Imlau let me know that today is the last day for the food fair shopping, and our joy is that there are still a few things available. Online sales are going to end at 6 p.m. So if you've been waiting till the end, this is the end. Get in there. Leftover event spaces, if there are any, will be announced in the intercom and on our Facebook page as they occur. So far, we've raised just over $9,000. So if you haven't done anything yet, consider getting in there. Let's see if we can get it over 10. So that is joyful that it's doing that well. On May 11th and again on May 25th, I'm holding a group called Beyond Widening the Circle of Concern that will be at 6 p.m. And the link is in the intercom. What we're going to be doing is talking about, we read Widening the Circle together this year, and I've got some ideas for what we're going to be doing next year with what we read and what people said. But this is one more chance for you to go. You can come to either meeting or you can come to both meetings if you have a lot to say. Come to those meetings and help us figure out what, if anything, our church needs to do to be more welcoming. What does welcome look like coming from us? And find out some things we're going to be doing next year and offer your opinions. So come on down to those. Again, there's one on May 11th and another on May 25th at 6 p.m. We'll be talking about what we're doing next year and getting your ideas about what we could do next year. Let's share together now the names of anyone we know who could use some special care and attention right now. Feel free to type their names into the chat. Let us know what's going on, and may the love of this community hold them all. May the light of our community shine on all the broken places of the world. May the work of our community comfort all those who are marginalized and oppressed, silenced or at risk. May we never look away when we're needed. May all those who are grieving be comforted, and may you be comforted. May all those who are tired find rest. May you find rest. May the broken places be healed. May you be healed. And may all those who are filled with joy and laughter be abundant. Each week we light 3 virtual candles, one for the joys and sorrows we've shared out loud and one for the names we write in the chat. And one last candle for all those joys and all those sorrows which are deeply held, but which have not been spoken here today.
Oh, my soul.
first reading is Humanizing Mom by Jane Rani Rezepka. On Mother's Day, one expects to read about the wonder and glory of motherhood. While I can tell you from personal experiences that we mothers like to be appreciated, I can also tell you that a rosy and sentimental Mother's Day column always refers to mothers in some family. The picture painted there is not me, not my mom, not my grandmother's. In my family, mothers do not suffer any more than other mortals, nor are we particularly unsung. We complain when we trip over shoes on the living room floor, and we expect a little praise for carrying the daily grand accumulation at the bottom of the stairs up the aforementioned stairs. We do not deserve or expect devotion from our children. We wanted to have children. It was our idea. If they come around from time to time when they are grown-ups, we are ever so glad. But if they live their lives as secure and independent souls, we value that. Motherhood in my family is not always the most important job in the world. Some of us are actually good at it. Some of us shuffle along and do our best. And a few are better off in other professions. We try to face that. Mother's Day is no day to romanticize parenting. Parenthood. Parenting is a down-to-earth process if ever there was one. So this Mother's Day, let's humanize mom. Thank her for doing what she could, given all the dirty sex. Thank her for loving you as well as she was able, in spite of your 3 years in junior high. And then let her thank you for the privilege of being your mother.
This is a neat poem called The Many Names for Mother, Father, Parent by Janet H. Bowering. Blessed is the person who feeds and warms, washes and comforts a child and soothes them in illness, for they shall be called caregiver. Blessed is the person who gives shelter, food, clothing, books, and toys, for they shall be called provider. Blessed is the person who opens doors in the child's experience, who explains the puzzling and the wonders of the mysterious, for they shall be called teacher. Blessed is the person who shields a child from that which will wither or warp, who protects a child from abuse and exploitation, who guards against bullying and scorn, for they shall be called defender. Blessed is the person who takes the time to listen, who's there for a child in the darkness, who is aware of the tears and the fears, who speaks the words of encouragement in moments of despair, for they shall be called sustainer. Blessed is the person who guides a child in the search for beauty, who encourages them at what is daunting, who steadies them as they explore new experiences, who fires their aspirations and their dreams, for they shall be called inspirer. Blessed are all these persons who help bring an infant along the many paths to maturity, for in them is the future well-being of humanity. Please join me in one moment of meditation or the spirit of prayer.
Our second reading this morning is an excerpt from Why I Hate Mother's Day by Anne Lamott. My main gripe about Mother's Day is that it feels incomplete and imprecise. The main thing that ever helped mothers was other people mothering them. A chain of mothering that keeps the whole shebang afloat. I am the woman I grew up to be, partly in spite of my mother, and partly because of the extraordinary love of her best friends and my own best friends' mothers, and from surrogates, many of them whom were not women at all, but gay men. I have loved them my entire life, even after their passing. No one is more sentimentalized in America than mothers on Mother's Day. But no one is more often blamed for the culture's bad people and behavior. You want to give me chocolate and flowers? That would be great. I love them both. I just don't want them to be out of guilt. And I don't want them if you're not going to give them to all the people who helped mother our children. But if you are going to include everyone, then make mine something like M&Ms. And maybe flowers you picked yourself, even from my own garden. The cut stems wrapped in wet paper towels, then tin foil and a wax paper bag from my kitchen drawers. I don't want something special. I want something beautifully plain. Like everything else, it can only fill me if it is ordinary and available to all. Our centering song today is number 1012, When I Am Frightened. The words will be in the chat screen. Please keep your mics muted and sing along at home if you like.
Thank you, Barb and Bruce. We have a wonderful piece of special music this morning. C.W. Smith doing Mamas, Don't Let Your Babies Grow Up to Be Cowboys.
cowboys sing along. Cowboys ain't easy to love, and they're harder to lose. They'd rather give you a song than diamonds or gold. Lone Star belt buckles and old faded Levi's, and each night begins a new day. If you don't understand it, he don't die young. You'll probably just fade away. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. Don't let them pick guitars or ride them old trucks. Let them be doctors and lawyers and such. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. 'Cause they never stay home, they're always alone, even with someone they love. Cowboys like smoky old pools and clear mountain mornings. Puppies and children and girls of the night. Them that don't know him won't like him, and them that do sometimes won't know how to take him. He ain't wrong, he's just different, but his pride won't let him do things that you know that he can feel he's right. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. Don't let them pick guitars or drive them old trucks. Let them be doctors and lawyers and such. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. 'Cause they'll never stay home, they're always alone, even with someone they love. Someone they love.
Happy Mother's Day, first of all, to each and every one of you moms and mamas. Many of you have some familiarity with the Christian Bible, and you might know that in the Christian New Testament, right, there's a huge gap from the time Jesus of Nazareth was a child of 12 or 13 up until he starts his adult ministry in his early 30s. These years are just missing. In fact, there isn't much about the years from birth to 13 either, only a mention of his teaching adults in the temple. In the second century, there were some additional books and stories written to explain these years. And one of the most popular was called The Infancy Gospel of Thomas. If you've never read it, it is a hoot. I highly recommend it. The book has never been a canonical gospel. In other words, it's not part of the Bible. But I can say this, the author was definitely a parent. How do I know? Well, according to the author, here's what Jesus did in just a few months span when he was a kid. He brought his clay birds to life, made them fly away, which scared the sandals off the other children he was playing with. Another child literally stirred Jesus's mud puddle with a stick, and Jesus caused him to fall down dead. And when the kid's parents went to tell Jesus's father, Joseph, what he'd done, he struck them blind. Then he laughed and revived everybody. He smarted off to a teacher. He broke his mother's water pitcher and then did a miracle and carried the water back in his robe. Now, I don't know about your children or you as a child, But if mine had been able to do miracles, I'm pretty sure their rap sheet would have resembled that list in every possible way. Motherhood doesn't come with an instruction booklet, not even for the mother of some kind of Messiah. Oh, you can read the books. There's books out there. Don't get me wrong. You'll find that no two agree, and the third and the fourth disagree with the first and the second. Mr. Rogers, Dr. Spock, attachment parenting, free range parenting, helicopter parenting, mommy and me classes. Your child comes into the world and suddenly you are the expert on survival. Even if you're confused and frightened, even if you're unready, even if you're unwilling. Motherhood is more than just a status gained by the physical act of giving birth. It's more than the act of adopting or raising a child. In fact, I've never seen a Mother's Day card which in any way represents the full range and reality of motherhood. The cards I can find are all upbeat and funny or inspirational or just perfect for, I don't know, Carol Brady, Claire Huxtable, June Cleaver. The cards I see are perfect for them. The cards I see are not perfect for me, for Roseanne Connor. There are few cards that recognize the best mothers for being more than a two-dimensional mom. I want cards that recognize that these incredible people held down jobs and relationships and had hobbies and interests, or maybe they didn't because they didn't have any time. There are few cards that say, I know there were times it cost you to be there for me as well as you did. I know you were human and I love you all the more for it. For the less perfect among us, there are no cards that say, thanks, Mom, for not just killing me when I threw SpaghettiOs on the beige rug. I know you wanted to. There are no cards that write poems about the car trips and the vaccines and the smelly laundry and the tears and the trips to school and sometimes the trips to the police station or the prison or the morgue. Nobody writes poems about that. There are no cards that say, I wish we liked each other more. I couldn't find a card that said, I didn't think I would survive you, or I didn't think you'd survive me. Let's face it, if words have baggage, mother comes with three suitcases, a trunk, and two carry-ons at times. Talking about mothers is hard. Who are our mothers? Our mothers may be amazing. They may be June Cleaver. Happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day to every one of you amazing, perfect moms out there. Thank you. Thank you for everything you did. Thank you for everything you do. Our mothers may be the people who physically gave us life by internally gestating us. That's not a prerequisite. Our mothers were the ones who were there. They're the people who heard that song, Mamas Don't Let Your Babies Grow Up to Be Cowboys, and thought, oh my God, you mean I have to worry about that too? I'm just trying to keep them from sticking a fork into the electrical socket. Our mothers cut our meat small enough we wouldn't choke. And when we choked anyway, they reminded us not to eat so fast. They were there at 3 a.m. with the chicken pox or the migraine, or the first time someone asked us out on the date, or the first time someone told us no, they didn't want to go out on a date. They cleaned our skinned knees and they taught us that silly song, and then they didn't scream when we sang it again and again and again. And they played that game with us with all the pieces, you know, the one, all the pieces and the dice and the cards. for all the moms who worked and worried and made sure we had dinner and were there to clap and hug and did it mostly right. This is your day. Thank you. But America created that image of the perfect mother as the only mother. And many of us can't superimpose that image with complete success on our lives. We're real. Admittedly, almost nobody wakes up and thinks, how can I take out my child today? Though many teenagers swear that we do. Mothering is about being present or absent, friendly or cold, raising a child or occasionally wondering what happened to the child they birthed. What works for one mother and child is a disaster for the next. And anyone who writes a book that guarantees it will tell you how to be a good mother is either delusional or has a background in selling bridges to tourists. Mothers create another person through their presence or their absence, their words and actions, but they don't own their creation. They can model ways to be in the world or allow their lack of modeling to speak for itself. But they can't control their child's ways of being in the world. Mothers can be upgraded, but children are often not backwards compatible. And that's not a bad thing. If mothering is relational, though, this implies that it's designed to change and develop over time. And that kind of change isn't always second nature. We hold on to the relationships we remember. But not every mother enjoys every minute of the process. Writer Anne-Marie Kelly Harbaugh says, I long to celebrate Mother's Day my way, quietly, selfishly. I spend every day with my family. On Mother's Day, I just want to be left alone to do whatever I want, whenever I want, the way I could before I became a mother. I fantasize about sitting on my front porch with a seasonal beverage and reading in the breeze. I want to garden, but only a little. I want to jog without a stroller. I want to eat a salad from start to finish with no interruptions, vegetable complaints, or ketchup. I wouldn't mind pushing a button to summon my children briefly. I would smile at them, feel pride, but then I would want to push another button and send them away again. I wouldn't mind a date with my husband, but preferably to two different movies. In his, some fellow could make clever quips as he kills bad guys, stops runaway trains, and beds large bosom beauties. My film would be foreign, subtitled, and evoke memories of my time as a college student overseas. Perhaps we could meet for dinner afterwards, but only at a restaurant where they use real napkins. And none of the choices is macaroni and cheese. We're still talking about our mothers. Some of our mothers were there and not there. They kept us from running into the road and made sure we didn't starve, and they did their best, but their hearts were somewhere else. Some were too tired. Some were too sick. Some were alone and some wish they were. Some really wanted to help with the homework, but they lost their tempers. Others tried to help and they just couldn't do that eighth grade math. They got it wrong. They screwed it up. They screwed us up. They heard they shouldn't let us be cowboys and thought, oh God, what next? I quit. And then they came back and they tried again. For all the mothers who tried and failed and tried again, for all the mothers who never seemed to get it right, and they still didn't leave, we celebrate their struggle and we see their pain and we honor them. If we grew up to be cowboys, we ride bravely because of them. We're not afraid of sudden changes or mistakes. We learned to be independent. We picked ourselves up and we tried again and again. So were those all of our mothers? Well, no. Some of our mothers weren't there. We never met them. They left as soon as we were born. They walked away or ran away. They faded away over months and years. Some died. Some just weren't around. Some we lost to alcohol or drug addiction. Some to the promises of boyfriends or husbands or partners. To a bigger city and a new life. Some we lost to jail or death or mental illness. Some could not keep us, but gave us up with tears in their eyes and an ache in their heart. Some just walked away. Some of us became cowboys, wild and fierce gunslingers, mostly because no one ever told us it was a bad idea. Today we honor those mothers who could not stay, who did not stay. We honor those who wished it could have been different and those who never realized there was another way. Mothers do the work of the world's heart. Some of them are related to us by blood or adoption or marriage. Some are recognized and they get called mom or mommy, mama, ma. Others of us are raised by granny, or grandma, or nana, or oma. And let's face it, some of our mothers were called Bill or Frank. Some of our mothers are called dad because no one else was there. And some of our moms are not related to us at all and never get recognized. Some of us, our only mom is the teacher or the lunch lady of our childhood, the librarian who took extra time, the storyteller who inspired us. For some of us, our only mom is the Girl Scout leader or the minister, the cashier at the gas station who watched for us after school and listened to our day between stocking shelves and cleaning floors. It's okay. Today, we honor all those who fill the spots in our hearts marked mother. For the mothers who raised us with love and care, thank you. Thank you so much. For the mothers who didn't get it right, but tried as hard as they could, thank you. Thank you. For the mothers who got it wrong, completely, totally, horribly wrong, we recognize that just as we are shaped by our lives, you were shaped by yours. We honor the fact that you gave us life. We sorrow for your pain. For the mothers who came later and stayed, thank you. You are as real as anyone else. For the mothers who left and never forgot, thank you, we see you. For the mothers who regret nothing because they did great and there was little to regret, thank you. For the mothers who regret nothing because they don't even understand what there is to regret, thank you for trying. For the mothers who mourn because they lost a child, we see you. Thank you. Bless the mothers who let us grow up to be cowboys and firemen and teachers and doctors and everything else. Bless all who do the work of loving and guiding children in this world. Bless all the children who grow up to have children themselves. Mamas, whoever you are and whoever your children grew up or grow up to be, thank you. Be blessed. Have an amazing Mother's Day. Amen.
We extinguish this chalice but carry the light in our hearts to shine the way for all those who we mother and guide. Our final song today is 9, Sleep My Child. The words will be in the chat screen. Please keep your mics muted and sing along as you wish.
Cheryl Lacey Donovan writes, mother is a verb. It's something you do, not just who you are. When you leave today, go in peace to love and mother one another. Cowboy or lawyer, waitress, warrior, or king. Peace and may it be so. Our final hymn today is Hymn of Valor, which Bruce is going to play. The words will be in the chat.
Thank you.